Hi, I'm Valder Beebe. I'm the host and the visionary of the Valder Beebe Show's God Talk. Some people talk to God and others believe that God talks to them. Join us in conversation with authors, religious clergy, metaphysicians, and regular people like you and I and God Talk. God Talk is a podcast available on FM radio, Roku TV, and online. Subscribe at valderbeebeshow.com. You can also subscribe at youtube.com/valderbeebeshow. Join the conversation of God Talk. I'll see you there.
Good day and welcome back to the Valder Beebe Show. My next guest is Doris Severon. She's the Vice President of Academic Colleges at the University of Phoenix. Doris, welcome to the Valder Beebe Show.
Thank you for having me.
Okay, I want to talk about this new survey, and that survey is supposed to reveal the impact of working moms and gender equality. It talks about the pandemic. Has it taken women backwards in the workforce? I can't believe the title, but is that true?
So we actually have found some encouraging news. So we did the survey to find out what kind of impact the pandemic is having in progress being made for equity for women. And we found women at a high percentage have indicated that they feel like they're either close to or have met some of their career goals, and that they've had more opportunities for leadership roles. And they're starting to see an increase of flexibility, which really bodes well for women.
Are they seeing the flexibility because corporate culture is changing, or did the pandemic bring those changes in?
I think the pandemic probably created some opportunity and momentum towards flexibility. People had to pivot and move people to work from home, and they're starting to recognize that could be effective. And so they are starting to make decisions. Employers are starting to make decisions of either allowing people to stay at home and work from home full time, or they're creating some sort of hybrid model, which still adds flexibility to schedules.
What are the current challenges women are facing in general in the workplace then?
So we're still seeing equity in pay as the top issue. 38% of the women indicated they're losing hope that that's going to be resolved. And then we're still seeing a work-life balance piece. That's for men and women, but women unusually high because of the extra responsibility they indicated that they take on at home. And then we've seen both men and women say that it takes extra effort for women to have the same opportunities and promotions in the workplace. About 62% said that women have to work harder to achieve the same opportunities. And so there's definitely work to be done in that area to remove those challenges.
Are there some steps that working mothers can prepare those who decided to opt out of the workforce but now want to go back? Or do they need to do something special to prepare?
Yeah, so we knew in our annual optimism index, career optimism index, that working moms are feeling a little insecure about having the right skills to come back or take that next step. So we encourage mentoring. Those relationships can be very powerful, finding somebody that maybe is a step ahead in the career or has achieved some of the career goals and learning from them. We also feel like upskilling, there's lots of opportunities to continue to add skills to the resume. And then networking and building relationships to advocate for yourself. Those relationships can do the work for you sometimes by sharing opportunities that are available.
Do you have any advice for women who are in the workforce or out of the workforce?
So I'd say definitely keep focus and moving forward. We have the skills. Sometimes we're too hard on ourselves about waiting until we've perfected everything. Skills are transferable to different types of jobs, so paying attention to that. And then we have lots of resources on phoenix.edu/blog where there are career tips from our coaches and articles and suggestions on how to get started.
Doris Severon, thank you so very much for that information. As women struggle with so many matrix of decisions in their life, I think this might be a good avenue for them to consider. Thanks for being my guest on the Valder Beebe Show.
You're welcome. Thank you for having me.
Hi, I'm Valder Beebe. I host the Valder Beebe Show, broadcast on radio and television. And this is my phone pouch. My phone pouch is a great invention. It allows me to go hands-free, pocket-free, purse-free, even belt-free. Head on over to myphonepouch.com.